You've known Britt's mom all along?
No, but I've seen her.
Where?
Here in town the other day at Kelly's with Britt. She's a bit older and she looks a bit different, but that's definitely her.
Hi!
Hello, beautiful.
Hey, how are you? Hi, guys.
Hi.
Oh, hey. What's going on?
Hilbrecht has managed to elude the authorities for quite some time.
Yes, but you are an authority, and I'm sure you will find a way to bring her to justice.
Hilbrecht is a dangerous woman. And God knows what she's capable of, or who's going to fall victim to her next. Tonight is a celebration of Mac and Felicia's new start. And since we don't have any clue where Obrecht is, let's just not think about her anymore.
Well, I consider that to be an excellent idea.
Orin has a mother? Wow, it's kind of amazing to think she wasn't hatched.
That's what she said.
So, what have you discovered about this maternal figure?
That she used to experiment on live patients back in the day?
What? Really? What exactly was she attempting to ascertain?
Unclear. She did accomplish losing her medical license, but the path runs cold after that.
Well, Sabrina saw her with Westmore the other day.
Wait a minute. The mother is in Port Charles.
Yes, but we still don't know for sure if she's up to something with Britt regarding baby.
What if the baby's the subject of one of her experiments?
You know, nothing would surprise me. From what we've learned about Westmore's mom, she sounds terrifying. I wonder what's keeping Patrick. Childbirth class should be over by now.
I wonder what's happened to our pregnant party planner. Shouldn't she be here by now?
She should be. And our guests of honor as well. And where's Kevin and Lucy?
It's time!
No, okay, it's okay. The surprise hasn't happened yet. My Felicia didn't arrive.
No, I know, but they're almost here. We saw their car.
You did?
Yeah, but they didn't see us.
Are you sure?
Everybody, thank you so much for coming, but it's time to gather around the door. They're almost here!
And I have a big surprise for you, Miss Anna Devane.
Okay, that's it right here. Shh, quiet. Hit the lights.
Surprise! Were you surprised? Shocked is more like it.
You guys, I can't believe you did this.
Who do we think first?
Well, Anna and Duke are hosts as best man and woman.
No, the genius planning behind all of this is your daughter.
Oh, thank you, Maxie.
Thank you. It was very sweet of you. You really should now.
I know, especially with the baby coming so soon.
Just because I can't see my feet doesn't mean I can't throw an awesome celebration for the two of you.
We love you, sweetheart.
Well, you guys are getting married again. Finally, and that deserves a party. I'm just happy that we made it back from the birthing class in time to surprise you.
Et tu, Duque?
Ah, you have to wear the costume if you're gonna perform.
Perform?
Us? Uh-huh.
What?
Are you friends with Matt and Felicia?
The hosts and I go way back.
It's all your daughter's fault, so I'm gonna let her explain.
Well, you both said that you didn't want bachelor or bachelorette parties, so.
We did. Right, we did. Yeah, we're too old for that kind of thing.
But you're not too old for karaoke.
Oh, brilliant idea.
Sing? You want me to sing? I haven't even had one drink.
Relax, I'm gonna show you how it's done. I'm gonna sing a special song for the bride and groom, but by the end of the night, I wanna see everybody up here singing. Let's make some memories.
Come on, Maxie, we want to hear a song. No, wait, you need my help.
Thank you.
That's an interesting accent. Where are you from?
New Jersey.
I'll have a white wine and a scotch on the rocks, please. Thank you.
Okay, everyone, this song is for the bride and groom. Go into the chapel and we're gonna get married. Go into the chapel and we're gonna get married. Gee, I really love you and we're gonna get married. Go into the chapel of love.
I'm not so sure about this karaoke, but perhaps you and I could tangle later.
Depends how much I have to drink.
Come and drink up.
That's right, Commish. Enjoy, as if it's your last night on Earth, because it is.
Best karaoke number ever. You think? Yeah, I put Maxie and the Maxettes to shame.
Bravo!
Wow, I guess I had no idea you were such a karaoke enthusiast.
Well, it was an enthusiasm that Maximus and I used to share. That was such a stirring rendition. You had the whole crowd on its feet.
Well, thank you, Spinelli. I haven't done that in a long time.
Yeah, right, probably not since our non-wedding, and before that, what, the first time that we...
I remember.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, it's time to pop the champagne. It's time for us to make a toast.
Are you sure you don't want to wait till Lucy and Kevin get here?
No. They'll be here soon. As soon as the champagne starts blowing. Lucy would hate to miss a party.
I'm going to take one of these for Anna so she can start the toast.
Thank you.
All right, let's hear it for the singing Falconeries.
All right.
We would like to dedicate this song to Maxie Jones, our best friend, the daughter of the bride and the groom, and the most wonderful, generous person in the world.
You're having my baby. What a lovely way of saying how much you love me. You're having my baby. What a lovely way of saying you're thinking of me. I can see it. Your face is glowing. I can see it in your eyes. You're happy, you're knowing that you're having my baby. And I'm a woman I love, and I love what is going through you. Yeah. You're having my baby. You're a woman in love, and I love what it's doing to you. The need inside you.
I guess the toast can wait.
I see it showing.
At least until Kevin and Lucy get here.
Mm. Oh, I see it inside you, baby. Do you feel it growing? Are you happy you're knowing that you're having my baby?
It was really sweet.
But?
The lyrics were a little embarrassing.
Well, everything they said about you is true, though. I mean, giving the gift of life is the most generous gift you can give.
Exactly. Oh, wait, they're giving out the champagne for the toast.
All right, let's go.
I'll help too.
No. That's preposterous. You rest. I'll go. Ellie will keep you company, right?
Right. Great. The party is going really well. I hope so. Mac and my mom seem to be enjoying it. So, it sounds like some of the most important moments of you and Damien's relationship happened over karaoke. You just coincidentally decided to do karaoke tonight when you knew Damien would be in attendance.
Well, I thought my parents might enjoy it.
Oh, okay, so it had nothing to do with the fact that you're carrying his child.
You know, Spinelli mentioned to me you changed your mind about having children.
My heart hurts for Damien. I mean, I know how much he desperately wants to be a father someday, and Dante and Lulu are obviously going to be raising his child, which is a secret that I have to keep, so I figured it was the least I could do.
Oh, I see. You felt so strongly about that, you decided to sacrifice your deeply held convictions.
Yeah, that's right. And I have you to thank for that, so thank you.
Champagne for you right here, and then sparkling water for you and the wee one. Something wrong?
That's right. Pick it up.
Well, credit to Maxie. Karaoke was a very inspired idea.
Yeah, it was. It's good. Yes. Now drink it. Drink it, you stupid cow.
Oh, wait a minute. What am I thinking? No champagne before a toast.
What is this? Is this some rule that I haven't heard about?
Yeah, actually, it is. Section 12, subparagraph C of the WSB handbook. No agent shall sample their drink prior to a toast being made. That's
right. So dumped.
Okay.
All right.
Listen up, everybody.
Come on, everyone. Grab your glasses.
Listen up. Get your glasses.
Don't have to worry. We're not going to sing.
Promise. or dance.
Actually, we're here to propose a toast. We're very honored because Felicia and Mac asked us to stand up for them. And we're very proud and very, very happy to be here because they, like us, have a love that has stood the test of time. And it has survived. A love that is so strong that it has found its way to the surface. It has blossomed even in a time when you think winter will not end.
All right, you done?
I'm done.
Okay. Okay, so it's my turn. And really, all I wanted to say is that the only thing that could make tomorrow sweeter would be if your brother, Mac, if Robert was here with us. But sadly, he won't be. But I know for a fact that he wouldn't want you guys to delay your happiness even for a moment. So what I want all of us to do is to hold Robert in our hearts tomorrow when all of your friends and your beautiful, beautiful daughter celebrate what will hopefully be your best wedding yet. So everybody, please raise your glasses. Drink it now, damn you. To Felicia and Mac.
Felicia and Mac.
I may not be one of your patients, Doc, but I do happen to have feelings,
Lucy,
real feelings.
I really don't want to talk about this.
Why?
Now.
Why? Because you know deep down, I am right. I am right this time.
Hi. Hi. Oh, congratulations. Oh, I am. We are so happy for both of you. Oh, and I'm so sorry that we're late. I guess you did suspect that it was all Kevin's fault.
Why would it be my fault?
Because you had to use the V word.
Everything would be fine if my wife would remember that this is a party for you and for Mac. Not the time or the place to air petty grievances.
Petty? You are the one. It is so beneath you. You use the vampire!
Memorable entrance. What was all that about?
Nothing. Just my marriage falling completely apart. No. Don't touch your hair.
Right.
Is that all there is? If that's all there is, my friends, then let's keep dancing.
I'm sure you're exaggerating. Your man loves you.
Nuh-uh. My marriage is in shambles. I don't know why I'm surprised. You know, Doc is always gone. He's out of town. And then when he comes back, he's always busy with all this patient. That's all he cares about are those patients. I call him at work. He hates it. He hates it when I come with these genius ideas that I'm always having, like this one, couples massage. Not you and your partner, you and your pet.
Ooh.
Yeah, because animals are part of your family, right? And no one else is doing that. It would be wonderful. We'd make a lot of money, but he doesn't want to hear that. I really think deep down he's still awfully angry about the vampires.
I have a feeling something was missing. I don't know.
I don't know. Maybe I never got over this vampire thing. It just seems that Lucy is always mad at me now.
Is that all there is?
And when we actually are together, I spend half my breath apologizing to her. I can't even make her laugh anymore.
Come on, I got a great idea.
Well, given the tragic uneventfulness of my own love life, I have no right to be consulting you about yours. But I'm going to anyway. Maybe you and your man need to get away together somewhere.
Get away?
Yeah, take a trip. Where you can eat, drink, and have sex for days on end.
Oh, that would be absolutely heaven. I would... Oh, poop. It's not gonna happen. Doc is never going to leave his patients. They are his priority. You know, it's kind of like the words to this song. You know, I thought it was going to be heaven being married to Doc, and now I just find myself asking,
one day he went away.
Is that all there is? Is arguing,
I thought
I'd
die.
And fighting, and on and on.
And when I didn't,
I know that woman.
I said to myself, I know that all there is to love.
So much for our romantic toast.
Oh, God. Kevin and Lucy are hardly setting a sterling example of a happy marriage, are they?
I don't think your squabbling is going to affect Mac and Felicia. You know, their love, they know how precious it is because they lost it and they regained it. Just like us.
Yes, we did.
I think we should have our own personal toast.
Yes.
Here's to us. And all the wonderful things that we have to look forward to.
When that final
note comes,
and I'm breathing my last breath, I'll be saying to myself, is that all there is to love? Is that all there is? Is that all there is? If that's all there is, my friends, then let's keep dancing. Let's break out the booze and have a ball. If that's all there is.
Will you please tell me what's troubling you?
I just got jealous when I learned that karaoke is a thing that you and Maxie share. I just feel like you guys have a lot of things.
I'm not going anywhere. We are going to be together for a long time. We're gonna have plenty of things. And we already do.
So you don't care at all that I not sing a note?
Listen, but you danced divinely as you displayed in our number at the nurse's ball. But even if you didn't, and still be perfect.
No, I'm feeling a little odd.
Are you? You look a little flushed. Do you want some water?
No, it's fine. I think it's just maybe just a little stuffy in here. I think I'll take a step outside and get some fresh air.
I'll come with you.
No. We both can leave. We're the hosts. You stay, take care of our guests. I'll be back here in a minute.
Okay.
Love you.
I love you.
You sure you know that woman? I mean, she doesn't look like she runs in the same social circles as you do.
I know, but I really never, ever forget a face. I was in the park and I was passing out flyers when Lulu was missing and she was in the park. That's right, her hair's a little bit different. But she said something very strange to me.
Surprise, surprise. What did she say?
Some are driven by motives beyond the average person's comprehension.
What does that mean?
It means you don't have to be insane to do evil things. You might simply be evil.
Definitely something creepy. I wonder if I should tell Anna. Anna, I'm so sorry. Sorry about earlier. I beg your pardon. I hope you don't mind me asking.
Right.
Is that strange woman on the guest list?
I don't know what strange woman.
That strange woman that sang that very depressing song over there. She's gone.
Oh. Oh, excuse me. It's you. Albrecht, Faison's bitch!
Let me go!
It's over! Taking to the...
Come on. You didn't notice her, this kind of strange woman with blonde hair. She was wearing tinted glasses and she was singing that really depressing, kind of inappropriate dark song.
I never thought we would see these two again, but ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Norma and Eve.
What are they doing?
This one goes out to the ones we love.
I dropped the wrong person. Oh. Damn you, Anna Devine. Once again, you ruined my plans.
Nice legs, Mr. Scorpion.
You've always wanted me for my body.
Norma. I have missed you so.
Oh, and there it is. I've missed you too. And if I haven't made it clear enough already, I love you. Always.
I love you. Always.
Okay, you're gonna have to explain that.
Okay, I think it started at this women's conference on spirituality that Lucy attended, and Kevin wanted to crash it, so he made Mac help him. But look, drag or no drag, it's clear those four people have a lot of love between them. They're very lucky.
Where's Duke? Can't believe you missed that.
Oh, yeah. Duke? Oh, my God, Duke! Duke!